We are going to see a series of exercises on basic string functions using MS Excel. Some of the string functions available with MS Excel are concordinate, length, find, replace, substitute, exact, upper, and lower. Now we are going to see the first basic string function available with MS Excel, that is concordinate. Concordinate function will help us to combine the values which is available in two or more columns. For example, you have a data set. Let's say it is a student data set you have. You have the name of the student, first name of the student, last name of the student, and address of the student in three different columns. Now you wanted to send a communication to the address of the student. So what you will do, you have to combine all the three columns together, first name, last name, and then address of the student together, so that you can send some communication through post or through courier. So in this case, in a normal way, you will be copying it and you will be pasting it in the separate column. Like you copy the first name and you paste it, and you copy the second name and you paste it, last name you paste it, and then you copy the address of the student and then you paste it. But here Excel makes our job even more easier. For that we can make use of this concordinate function. If it is just one or two data, then this copy paste option sounds good. But if imagine there are 10,000 students studying in your institution and you wanted to send an important communication to them, it can be a mark sheet or it can be some intimation or something else you wanted to send, and which is very, very important, you have to send it immediately. So at the time, this concordinate function will help us to combine the data available in different columns and merge it with single column. So let me go with a concordinate function. So here I have given the syntax for concordinate with space and without space. First, let me talk about the concordinate function without space between the text. So here I have the set of data from A6 to C10. I have the data input, first name, last name, and address of the student. So here the name goes like this. The first name of the student is Ram and the last name of the student is Sita, and the address is number 6 Krishna Nagar, Chennai. Now here I wanted to combine all the first name, last name, and address together. So for that the syntax is type equal to and then type concordinate. It is concordinate, concordinate, and then type the text one. So here the text one is in A7, A column, seventh row, and then put a comma, and then give your text two. Text two is in column B, seventh row. So press that B7, and then type C7. C7 is the third input that you are giving. So all the three data should be combined together and should be shown in the single cell. So here you have to remember one thing: you need to give a space between the words, otherwise you'll be getting all the words together. So for that you have to include in the formula within quotes space. I repeat the syntax: type equal to, then type concordinate, open the round bracket, give the first reference cell. The first cell is A7, comma. You need a space between first word to second word. Otherwise, the output will be RAMSITA. There will be no space between Ram and Sita. If you want space, then type within quotes space. Open the quotes, press your space bar, and then close the close the within quotes, then comma. So Excel will understand this space between within the quotes, space within the quotes, it will understand that you are asking the Excel to separate these two words with the space. Then type the third column that you wanted to, and then close it so that you will be getting the output. So this is without, for without space, you don't have to type with the quotes. For the space, you have to type with the within the quotes. Then you'll be getting the output as Ram space Sita space number 6 space Krishna Nagar, then comma Chennai, you'll be getting the output. So let me proceed with the second data. It is first name is Virat, last name is Kohli, then the address is number 32 Patel Street, New Delhi. So here I'm typing equal to, then concordinate. My input is in A8. I'm giving A8, comma. Next input is in B8. I'm giving B8, comma. The third one is C8. I'm closing it. So here I have not given any space between the text. So you will be getting a output without space. I'm entering it. So here you can see Virat Kohli, number 32, Patel Street, New Delhi. This comma is available in the input itself. So that is why after number 32, there is a comma, and after Patel Street, there is a comma, because it is there in the output itself. So it has come as it is, but you cannot find the space between Virat space Kohli and space number 32 is not there because we have not given the space. So now let me rewrite it with the space equal to concordinate A8, then within quotes, I'm pressing the double quotes, I'm pressing the space bar, then I'm closing the double quotes, then I have to put a comma so that Excel will understand you are asking the Excel to give a space between first text to second text. Then I want the space between B8, after B8 also I need a space. Because once your first name and last name over, after the before the address starts, you need a space. So there, I'm opening the quotes. I'm pressing the space bar. Then I'm closing the quotes. I'm typing equal to symbol. Sorry, I'm typing the comma, and then I'm pressing. So here you can find there is a space between Virat space Kohli space number 32, then the whatever is there in the address C8, it has been reflected here also. Let me do one more, equal to concordinate, then text A9, comma, space within quotes, comma, last name, that is in B9, comma, space within quotes, comma, E9. Close it, enter. So you got Rohit Sharma, number 7, second cross street, Mumbai. Then similarly for the next input, concordinate A10. Comma, quotes, space, closing the quotes, comma, B10, comma, open the quotes, press space bar, close the quotes, give comma, and then give the address, enter. We got the concordinate function with the MS Excel. Thank you.